Hello students, welcome back to my channel. I am teacher Thaddeus Baluka, your chemistry mentor. In our today's lesson, I'm going to navigate the topic of nitrogen and its compounds. Our topic of interest today is nitrogen as compound, and the subtopic is ammonia. In our previous lesson, we were dealing with the laboratory preparation of ammonia. In our today's lesson, I'm going to deal with large-scale manufacture of ammonia. So by the end of the lesson, you should be able to name the raw materials for industrial preparation of ammonia and state the uses of ammonia. So we'll start by looking at the industrial manufacture of ammonia to use a process called the ABA process. So the industrial manufacture of ammonia is by ABA process. We need to look at the raw materials, their sources, and the conditions necessary, or rather what you call the optimum conditions. So the raw materials and their source, this is the simplest industrial process. The raw materials we use here is, one of the raw material is hydrogen. It is obtained from cracking of alkanes. The other raw material is nitrogen, which is obtained from the fractional distillation of air. So the two raw materials, hydrogen, which is obtained from the cracking of alkanes. We also have nitrogen, which is obtained from the fractional distillation of air. The optimum conditions, we have iron catalyst at temperature of 200 to 500 atmosphere pressure and 450 degrees Celsius. Remember, in this case, the iron catalyst is usually finely divided to increase the surface area for the reaction. It is also impregnated with aluminum oxide. The aluminum oxide there is a promoter. So make sure that you're able to capture this one very well. Number two, important to not talk about, you look at the pressure is 200 to 500, but you're supposed to give a specific temperature within that range. So you can give 400, at most you can give 200, you can give 300. For temperature, we normally pick, some books will talk about 400 to 500, but you have to give a temperature within that range. But it has to be a specific. Don't give a range, just give a specific temperature, like 400 degrees Celsius, 450. We continue. We look at the industrial manufacture of ammonia. We have the steps followed. We have the purification of the raw material, that the gases. We have the compression, you compress the gases, heating, which takes place in the heat exchanger, and reaction at the catalytic chamber. So it's that simple. Purification, compression, heating at the heat exchanger, and reaction that takes place in the catalytic chamber. By the end of this particular video, you should be able to know why are the gases purified? Why is compression necessary? What is the role of the heat exchanger? And what is the main reaction that occurred in the catalytic chamber? Watch until the end. So the industrial manufacture of ammonia by ABA process, we said the step follows. Step number one is purification. The nitrogen and hydrogen gases are first purified to remove dust particles through electrostatic precipitation or by use of the filters. Electrostatic precipitation is whereby the gases are passed through electrically charged rubber sheets, whereby it now able to remove some of the impurities like the dust particles. So the gases are purified to avoid poisoning the catalyst. So if you are asked why you need to purify the gases, because impurities will poison the catalyst. So we purify the gases to avoid poisoning the catalyst. The nitrogen and hydrogen are mixed in the ratio of 1:3, respectively. So if you add if you had 1 liter of nitrogen, this should be mixed with 3 liters of hydrogen gas. So the gases, once they have been purified via electrostatic precipitation, they are mixed in the ratio of 1:3. That is, nitrogen and hydrogen are mixed in the ratio of 1:3. So for every volume of nitrogen, you need 3 volumes of hydrogen gas. We continue. We are now purified the gases via electrostatic precipitation. Then you compress. After purification, the gases are compressed to increase the pressure. This is because high pressure favors the higher yield of ammonia, and the formation of ammonia is accompanied by decrease in volume. So the much of these, or rather, the real understanding of these will be understood, rather will be explained further in the topic of chemical, or rather dynamic equilibrium. We'll be able to understand the rationale why high pressure really favors the higher yield of ammonia, because the formation of ammonia is a reversible process, and the formation of ammonia is accompanied by decrease in volume, because 1 volume of nitrogen react with 3 volumes of hydrogen to form 2 volumes of ammonia. So the side of the reactant has 4 volumes, but the side of the product, which is ammonia, has only 2 volumes. So it has lesser volumes and is favored by higher pressure. But more information about this will be explained in Form 4 under the topic of rate of reaction and reversible reaction. So we go to the heat exchange. The heat exchange, the compressed gases are taken to the heat exchanger, whereby the gases are heated. Let's look at the role of the heat exchanger. So the role of the heat exchanger is that it is to heat the incoming gases. The incoming gases in this particular scenario is hydrogen and nitrogen. Remember, we require a temperature of about 450 degrees Celsius. So that temperature is now achieved in the heat exchanger, whereby the nitrogen and hydrogen are heated to that required temperature. So the role of the heat exchanger is also to cool the ammonia gas produced. And number 3, or rather the other part, is that the other role of the heat exchanger is to maintain the reaction temperature. So let's look at step number 4, the reaction at the catalytic chamber. This whereby the reaction will take place. Remember, the gases have been purified to remove impurities. The gases have been compressed to the required pressure of between 200 to 500 atmosphere pressure. And then it has also been, the gases, that is nitrogen and hydrogen, have been heated to the required temperature of between 400 to 500 degrees Celsius, which occurs in the heat exchanger. Now we go to the catalytic chamber, whereby now the catalytic chamber contains the finely divided iron catalyst, which is impregnated with aluminum oxide. So all the optimum conditions required for the reaction to take place have been attained. Now reaction takes place. So the main reaction occurs at the catalytic chamber, whereby the reaction takes place. Temperature is required between 400 and 500, which has been achieved in the heat exchanger. So at this particular chamber, that is the catalytic chamber, the nitrogen gas react with hydrogen gas to form ammonia. So the reaction occurs at the catalytic chamber, whereby all the optimum conditions have been attained. So we've looked at the heat exchanger. So let's note that the ammonia gas from the catalytic chamber is then cooled in the condenser to form liquid ammonia. A reacted nitrogen and hydrogen are recycled back. So when the ammonia has been produced, it is cooled again, it's a little bit cooled, then taken to a condenser, whereby now converted to liquid ammonia, which now can be kept for storage. So we are looking at here, we having the hydrocarbon, like the alkane, it is undergoing cracking to produce hydrogen gas. So we having the raw materials are hydrogen and nitrogen. Where they obtained, we have air, we carry out fraction or distillation to obtain nitrogen. Then we have hydrocarbon, which is now can be an alkane, which is undergoes cracking to produce hydrogen gas. The nitrogen and hydrogen gas are purified at the purifier, whereby we use the dust precipitators or the filters. Now the purified gases are taken to the compressor, whereby they are now compressed to attain the required pressure of about 200 to 500 atmospheres. When the gases have been compressed, now they are taken to the heat exchanger, whereby they are heated to a temperature of 400 to 500. Then now the hot gases are now taken to the catalytic chamber, which contains iron, which is filled with now, which is mixed with aluminium oxide. So the reaction occurs here to produce ammonia gas. So the ammonia gas now is taken back to the heat exchanger, whereby it is a little bit cool. We are saying the role of the heat exchanger to heat the incoming gas, which is nitrogen and hydrogen, and to cool the products, which is now the ammonia. So now when the gases have been cooled, now we have the ammonia, which is taken to the condenser, whereby it is now cooled. It is now in vapor form because the ammonia is highly volatile. So here it is, the ammonia produced is in gaseous form, but now when taken to the condenser, it is condensed to form liquid ammonia. So this one just showing you some of the properties of ammonia when you talk about the uses of ammonia. Like we are talking about ammonia will react with sulfuric acid to form ammonium sulfate. Ammonia will also react with phosphoric acid to form ammonium phosphate. And ammonia will also react with nitric acid to form ammonium nitrate. These are fertilizers, which are the products, which are one of the major uses of ammonia. Ammonia is a reducing agent. When reacting with copper oxide, it reduces copper oxide to copper metal and water, and also nitrogen is also produced. So the observation here will be now the black solid changes into a brown solid. So this one is just simply helping you to show how the exam can be tested. What is very much important for you to be able to understand. It's very important for you to be able to understand. Remember, in this case here, we are bringing the hydrogen. In this case, we are having hydrogen here. We're having the hydrogen, and we also have the nitrogen. And on this case, we're having ammonia. We're having ammonia here. So here we have ammonia on this side. We're having ammonia on this side. We are having nitrogen, hydrogen. Here we have, which is now the being taken the hot gases. But then we have one that the form of ammonia is taken back to the heat exchanger, which now a little bit will cause it to be cool. Rather, will cool the ammonia gas produced. Very important for you to be able to capture that particular point. We continue, and we look at the use of ammonia. Ammonia is used in softening hard water. Ammonia used in softening hard water and removal of grease stains. It's also used in manufacture of ammonium nitrate. Remember, it's not right to say ammonia is used in manufacture of fertilizers. You need to be specific. Manufacture of ammonium nitrate. You specify, or rather, manufacture of nitrogenous fertilizer. But the most common answer will be manufacture of ammonium nitrate, not manufacture of fertilizers. It's also used in manufacture of nitric 5 acid. It's also used in manufacture of hydrazine, that is used as a rocket fuel, and also used as a refrigerant. Then we have revision exercise. Dry ammonia was passed over heated lead 2 oxide, and the product passed over heated copper 2 oxide, as shown in the diagram. Then you're told to state the two observations made in the combustion tube. You're passing ammonia over lead 2 oxide. So remember, ammonia being a reducing agent will reduce lead oxide to lead plus water plus nitrogen gas. So the water, once it passes through this cooler pad, it condenses to form liquid water. When the liquid water reacts with the anhydrous copper 2 sulfate, to change from white to blue. So if you are told to state the observation in the combustion tube, the lead oxide will turn from yellow to gray, or it will turn from yellow to orange. Remember, it is yellow when cold, it is orange when hot, and finally it is gray. It is going to convert to be converted to lead metal, which is gray. So a student can write from the lead oxide changes from, rather the yellow solid changes to orange and finally gray. And the white anhydrous copper 2 sulfate changes to blue. The property of ammonia being in the experiment being the property of ammonia in the experiment is ammonia as a reducing agent, rather the reducing property. So we are able to look at that. The yellow solid changes to orange, then gray. The white anhydrous copper 2 sulfate changes to blue. And the property of ammonia being exhibited here is ammonia as a reducing agent, or rather the reducing property. And we have come to the end of our beautiful lesson today. To get such smart notes, such distilled notes, make sure that you're able to get a copy of Top Notch Book 3. Remember to subscribe and press on the notification bell so that you can be notified immediately I upload a new video. Keep it here, continue watching as we try to demystify and make chemistry simpler for you.